إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، يقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم: نضر الله امرأ سمع مقالتي فوعاها فحفظها فبلغها كما سمعها، فرب حامل فقه ليس بفقيه، وفي رواية رب حامل فقه إلى من هو أفقه منه. نضر الله امرأ says a dua from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. Over 1400 years ago, he made a dua for you that you can have it now and live by it now as if the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم alive and giving you that. نضر الله امرأ. النضرة هي الجمال في الوجه، إشراق الوجه، فهي جمال خارجي وجمال داخلي. It's a beauty in your face that people can see, and beauty in your heart from the cleansing of the sins. This is the dua of Nadra. And Nadra in the Quran, in Surah Al-Qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وُجُوهُ يَوْمَئِذٍ ناظرة إلى ربها ناظرة. Sounds the same, right? ناظرة with the letter ضاد. This is the beauty in the face. And that is when you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Reflect on that. Can you imagine how beautiful your face will be when you see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the ultimate pleasure in Jannah? This is how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam making dua for you to have your face in this life, that people when they look at you, they see the beauty of the deen, the beauty of the sunnah in your face, the way you are. People see that. People feel comfortable with that. People like you simply because of that. You remind people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way you look. And your heart is cleansed, because following the sunnah erases your sins. So in dunya you look good, and the day of judgment you look good, which is like the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saying, inshallah you will be beautiful in this world, and you will see the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the day of judgment, which is basically going to Jannah. All of this dua is for a simple, very simple thing. Let's see what it is. Sami'a maqalati, heard my word, or anything about my sunnah. And we know the sunnah three kinds: sunnah by action, sunnah verbal, and sunnah approved by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Any of those, you heard it, yani someone talked about it, like what I'm doing now. فَوَعَاهَا. Now let's focus on heard it. I said that to a brother, and I wanted to explain it. It's in a text. I wanted to explain it, and I'm very bad at texting, very slow. Lots of explanation, and I don't know his background and all of that, so I just gave him the ayah that refers to that. When I gave him the hadith, subhanallah, it was more than what I expected from him. He focused on the word that I avoided to explain because he might not understand it. And he said, Sheikh, Subhanallah, it all starts by listening. I said, wow. I said, maybe that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He commanded us in Surah Al-Anfal, and He said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ. Obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the messenger. No, I'm sorry. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَلَا تَوَلَّوْا عَنْهُ وَأَنْتُمْ تَسْمَعُونَ. Oh, you who believe, obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His messenger, and don't turn your back while you are listening. Yani you heard it, and you understood it, and you refused it. And then He said, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَهُمْ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ. Don't be like those people who said, we heard, but they actually did not hear it. And who are those? يَلَّا بُالشَّبَابْ. Mean? Who are those? Who said, we heard it, but they did not hear it? Huh? كفرة منافقون. أحسن. Look at the منافقون, what they say. In Surah Muhammad, they said, حتى إذا خرجوا من عندك, أو سورة, yeah, سورة محمد, حتى إذا خرجوا من عندك قالوا للذين أوتوا العلم ماذا قال آنفا. طب ما أنت قلت قاعدين. You were sitting with them. You were listening to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. As soon as they leave, they ask the people of knowledge, what was he talking about? It's like you're listening, but you're not listening. You can hear the voice, but I guarantee you I can ask a question now and you'll be lost and you say, what was that question again, Sheikh? That happens. You think you're listening? What's the last word I said? No. The last word. See? Not listening. Listening is the last word. Al-Muhim. So it starts by listening. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger called, نَضَّرَ اللَّهُ امْرَأً سَمِعَ مَقَالَتِي, heard my word. Now it can be Sunnah, it can be Quran too. But the Prophet ﷺ want to emphasize the listening. He did not leave it there. He could have said, سَمِعَ مَقَالَتِي فَبَلَّغَهَا, صح? لَا. He could have said, heard my word, and then pass it on. But no, he wants you to do other two things. سمع مقالتي فوعاها, يعني صار قلبه وعقله إلها وعاء, احتواها في قلبه, يعني فهمها. فوعاها, he contained it, he became like a container for it, it's in his heart, he understood it mentally and he accepted it in his heart. Confirming that, even though that may include memorizing it. No, he confirmed it. He said, فَحَفِظَهَا. حَفِظَهَا, memorized it. This to tell you that when you say a hadith, the best is to say it as is. Even though the scholars are a little flexible with that, you can say it by the meaning. But unfortunately, people come and tell you such and such, like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said such and such. No, Habibi, there's no such and such in Quran. In Quran, you better say it exactly as is or be quiet. Hadith, the scholars let you slide by it. But not Quran. You either know the ayah or you don't know the ayah. You don't read the Quran and break it left and right and give me the meaning of it. This is not acceptable. The scholars unanimously agreed you cannot report the Quran in the meaning. It has to be memorized. So the Prophet ﷺ said, heard the word, understood it, memorized it. Why did you memorize it? Give me a benefit of memorizing it. To pass it on. To benefit from it yourself, to refer to it in the future, to get the hasanat of memorizing it like you memorize the Quran, and to learn it. And then the main thing is to pass it. You are not a special ummah, but because you enjoin good and forbid evil, and this is enjoining good. شو الآية يا شيخ؟ كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر. يعني إذا لا تأمر بالمعروف ولا تنهوا عن المنكر فأنت لست من هذه الأمة أو خيرية هذه الأمة. خيرية هذه الأمة بالأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر. والله سبحانه وتعالى لعن أهل الكتاب على إيش؟ كانوا لا يتناهون عن منكر فعلوه. They never enjoyed good and forbid evil. And we do. So we became the best. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's messenger heard, he said, you heard my speech, you contained it, you understood it, you memorized it, فَبَلَّغَهَا. Then you go on and you pass it on. I said that before, one of the hadith scholars, he used to hear the hadith. And then he goes home and he reads it to his servant. She's not interested, like most of the people. You talk to people and they walk away. You sit in a gathering, you bring religion and boom, everyone is either leaving or changing the subject or interrupting you or becoming a scholar already. All of that, just to, so she was like walking around and he's chasing her and talking to her. You know, I just heard the Prophet ﷺ was saying such and such and all of that. And she just keep going. He said, Wallahi, I know you're not interested, but I have to say it to someone so I can memorize it good and keep it. What do you get from that? العلم على المناقشة كما قال المأمور رحمه الله العلم على المناقشة أثبت منه على السمع. When you learn something and you pass it on and you teach it, it affirms it and makes you understand it a lot better. Ask me why. Are you awake? He's not. Why? Thank you. It's a good question, by the way. Why? Because in order for you to talk, you better know what you're talking about. And that's why the Prophet ﷺ said, heard it, understood it, memorized it, passed it. How can I teach you something if I don't understand it myself? And that's really what started that text between me and that guy. He had a post on Facebook. Good wording and good things all the way. Except he said, being poor is not from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's from the shaitan. Give charity, Allah will give you money. Look for a job, work hard, you earn money. All that sounds good. But he said, being poor is from the shaitan. And he cited the ayah, الشيطان يعدكم الفقر. A shaitan promised you poverty. So I wanted to comment. People are يعني, so happy about it and into it and comments and all that. I said, I don't want to ruin the fun. So I texted him in private. I said, Habibi, shaitan promises poverty, doesn't give the poverty. He doesn't make you poor. He cannot make you poor. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala huwa al-razzaq. Before you're born, your sustenance is written. Before you're born, يعني, when you are 4 months old, your sustenance is written. والله سبحانه وتعالى قال في سورة النجم وأنه هو أغنى وأقنى. He is the one who gives you richness and he is the one who makes you poor. And in سورة الفجر الله سبحانه وتعالى قال فأما الإنسان إذا ما ابتلاه ربه فأكرمه ونعمه يعني أغنى فيقول ربي أكرما وأما إذا ما ابتلاه فقدر عليه رزقه يعني أفقره فيقول ربي أهانا. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, when the human being is tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by making him rich, and tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by making him poor. So in both situations, it's all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what got us into the conversation. And that's what actually prompted me to talk about the hadith altogether. Because subhanallah, it is such a dua that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam makes for us to hear anything. He said, نَظَرَ اللَّهُ امْرَأً سَمِعَ مَقَالَتِي. Anything the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam talked about, regardless how small, similar to saying, بَلِّغُ عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةً, report or relate about me, even if it's one verse. But the condition is what? To hear it, to understand it, to contain it, memorize it, and to pass it. Another thing he fell in, did not do right, he said, Ammu, that's why, because I'm not a scholar, I always say at the end, Wallahu A'lam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. I said, good one. But do you know, brother, that you should say Allahu A'lam when you know, not when you don't know. When you know, you say what you say, and you always leave room for mistake. You say Wallahu A'lam. Otherwise, you are falling in a dangerous sin close to shirk. قُلْ إِنَّمَا In Surah Al-A'raf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال قُلْ إِنَّمَا حَرَّمَ رَبِّيَ الْفَوَاحِشِ مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمَا بَطَنْ وَالْإِثْمَ وَالْبَغْيَ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ وَأَنْ تُشْرِكُوا بِاللَّهِ مَا لَمْ يُنَزِّلْ بِهِ سُلْطَانًا وَأَنْ تَقُولُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. To say anything about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala without knowing it is true, then you are falling in lying about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's the worst kind of lie next to shirk. So, نَضَّرَ اللَّهُ امْرَأً سَمِعَ مَقَالَتِي فَوَعَاهَا فَحَفِظَهَا فَبَلَّغَهَا فَرُبَّ حَامِلِ فِقْهٍ إِلَى مَنْ هُوَ أَفْقَهَ مِنْهُ. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you do that because some people hear the word and memorize it, and that's all they want to do. They're not going to get busy in deep understanding of it. You come and you give it to someone who is specialized in that, he will benefit you more of it. Yani you might come, just like what he did, he put a post, sounded good, but he doesn't understand. Like he said, Wallahu A'lam. How many of you benefited from that now? Wala wahid, mashallah alaykum. Abakara. انت عارف شو السؤال؟ شايف؟ He doesn't know the question. You know the question? طيب. Tell me, repeat the question. How many of you know when to say Allahu A'lam?
When you know it.
That's the benefit. You used to know that before, right? I mean, I personally, when I wanted to answer him, I was digging deep into the things. Maybe I understood it, but I never really understood it. Does that make sense? You know how sometimes you think you know and you don't? Many of us think that they're praying right, but when they come and hear a lecture about praying, wow, I didn't know that. Yeah, it's because you don't dig deep, or you don't study, or you don't learn all of that. So you benefit from that. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us, like some, there are some people specialized in hadith. That's why some of the people say about ulama al-hadith, they're not fuqaha. سمعت فيها يا شيخ سليمان. This is not true. In general, not true. But yes, some people may memorize and not know much. How many people memorize the Quran? and not know much about the meaning. A lot. Same thing with the hadith. So when you relate it, you benefit and you benefit other people. In conclusion, anything you hear about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pay attention, understand it, memorize it. And how do you understand it? Yani, brother Jamal, if you don't understand what I'm saying, what do?
Seek knowledge. Can you repeat again?
Repeat again, or you ask. So if you don't ask me, that means you understood it. But if you did not understand it and you walk away, you have a problem. That means you don't care about the whole thing. And that's why it amazes me sometimes when you say any questions and no one does. As soon as people leave, people would come and ask me questions. Brother, I mean, you come with shorts and your back showing and God knows what else. You're not shy. And asking a question, you're shy? شو رأيك يا شيخ محمد؟ والله مش عارف شو اسمك. شو اسمك انت يا زلمة؟ مهند. ايوه. مهنا. الله يهنيك يا رب. طيب يا شباب. So we got the point, inshallah, right? The steps. The العلماء call that مراتب تبليغ السنة. The levels of how you deliver the sunnah. You hear it. You understand it. You memorize it. You pass it. I add one more. And that is for the best, and it should be there. Guess what? You practice it. Which one comes? Practicing it as soon as you know it. Once you understand it, practice it before memorizing it. What's my sunnah in that? The Sahaba radiallahu anhum. What did they say? They said we used to learn 10 verses of the Quran, practice it, then memorize it before we move to the next 10. So practicing, then memorizing, and we do that. What do we do nowadays? The complete opposite. We memorize, we don't understand. How can we practice? How can we pass? Good night. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.